Hello friends, welcome you all in this one new lecture that is related to again the designing and the designing of that nanomaterials. In this talk, just I am trying to design some nanomaterials using this ASE GUI, and here we will try to design this monolayer by using this AI and then some nanotubes and then nanoparticles also. So let's begin. Okay, so let's start that ASE GUI. This can be opened by using a symbol, and then this type of window will open, and we have informed almost all components of this. And for designing, there is one part that is the setup one, where this the surface slabs one can design, nanoparticles one can design, nanotubes. But for monolayer, we have to use the method similar to our ZDIS tool. So let us open our CIF file and that ASI CIF file. So, and then let's go to this view and observe this. So the bonds. So this is that CIF file opened in this one. So we can create monolayer similar to that GUIS. So let us go to again this view and repeat this along in two direction. One is along x-axis, so just increasing this, and then along y-axis again I'm increasing, and it's looking like this, and then state inside that unit cell. So this is that the layer and the similar structure we also observed in GDIS, and at a different planes we can view using that alter Z. So this is our one plane, so here it's looking like almost a planar, and then alter X. So using this alter X, we can select this layer of atoms, four atoms, and then we will delete selected atoms. Then again also we can delete this selected atoms. So now this is monolayer, and now along this alter Y, this is that face which is XZ face, and this is our XY face, and this is that ZY face. So this is the method to design that monolayer, and then we can rotate by using this mouse, and we can save as this ASE. So let me save inside this. So this is SI, and I'm using this as ASE monolayer. So mono.xyz. Anyways, so this is monolayer. Now the next one is we can design nanoparticles also, and this is one of the good utility here. And here I want to design that gold nanoparticle, then get a structure. So this lattice constant and other things, these are given by default. And here that there are two methods given. One is layer specific, and so you can design layer by layer here, and whatever that parameters given here, I'm just directly using this and apply this. So this type of nanoparticle, it is generated by this tool. This is a bigger nanoparticle, and its size approximately diameter, number of atoms are mentioned here, that's about 675, and approximately diameters are, that is 28 angstrom. So this is that big nanoparticle. And if we want to design that, we want to change that size, like let me change this as 7. I'm randomly just changing this, then so the size will decrease like this, and here it's a 18.7 angstrom. And also if we want to control that number of atoms, then we have another method, that is this Wolf construction method. And here that everything is same here, but here one can approximately control the number of atoms. For example, I want to create one atoms so that closest to 40 atoms, then I just given here number of atoms here and then apply. So this is that nanoparticles, and number of atoms is about 43, and its diameter is 11.2 angstrom. So this is the method of designing of nanoparticle using this ZDIS, and save this as AU nanoparticle dot xyz. Now let us design nanotube. So here for the nanotube also we have this that is nanotube. Here one can design the nanotube by using a single elements only. For example, this carbon nanotube, and they say that is smearing is given as 5-5 with this length we can control. All this is that nanotube, and let me so in form of that bond, and also if you want to create that this is armature type thing, and let me create this zigzag. So 50, so this is that 50 armature type nanotube. So this is the simplest method. Thank you all. Happy learning.